Hello, I'm Graham Horton and welcome to today's video. Now in this video I'm going to show you an alternative way of capturing images to use in focus stacking programs. Traditionally you use a still image camera and you will take a number of images from the front of the subject to the back of the subject, then you put those into a focus stacking program like Eloquensoft or Photoshop or Affinity Photo and make one composite image from all of those images. In today's video I'm going to show you how you can do that very simply using 4K video. Now the process of using still images, if you've got a lot of slices, could take you maybe 15 minutes to create that complete sequence. Using 4K video you can complete that in just under 2 seconds, so you get the same amount of resolution, and I can show you that in this video. So the idea is to use a motorised slider, and the one I'm going to use today is the MIOPS Slider Plus. I did a review of that and I'll put a link to that in the video description below if you wanted to look at the full review for the product. So I'm going to use my Canon EOS M6 Mark II with the 7 Artisans 60mm f2.8 macro lens, but you could use this with a 50mm lens and extension tubes if you wanted to get close up, such as I've got on the table here. Got a bit of an additional light to give me the correct exposure for the video. So the process is the camera will advance, it starts recording before you get to the leading edge of your subject, will advance through the subject recording video all the time, and when it's got to the back of the subject it will stop recording. The MIOPS mobile app is an ideal solution for that, and that is why I've chosen this particular review. Now on the desktop you can see the complete setup I have. So we've got the MIOPS slider. You can see that I've got a scale on there. It gives me an indication of just how much travel I'm getting, so I can match that to the travel of the subject. My additional light source, and here we've got the subject with this little doll, and from the front of the subject to the back of the subject is about 4 centimetres, so that's the amount of travel we need to put in the slider. Here is the smartphone running the MIOPS app. So let me take you through the complete setup for this process. So we started the app and the camera's connected. So it's connected via Bluetooth to the device, making sure my lead is plugged into the back camera for the remote control, which is from the Slider Plus capsule, and it triggers the EOS M6 via that 2.5mm Canon connection. So the first thing I want to do is to actually go into focus stacking, and if we look at the app, that is the bottom left hand tile. So if I tap that, it takes us into the focus stacking program, and we need to be setting up our point A, which will be the closest point of the setup. So by setting point A to the front and setting point B to the back, we have enough travel to create our video for this sequence. So let's go back to the app and we'll go to the center portion, which is Mark Slider. Tap that and you can see it's set your A position. So I'm going to move the slider to the left, which will then take the focus from the back of the image to the front of the image. And I want to set it roughly on the front of that elbow of the model. So let me switch to a camera view and I'm going to move the slider using the app, and you can probably see I've got the left and the right, but across the top of the app you've got the pads which will allow me to change the position. The default is 1.14 micron per step. If it's used times 10, that's 11 microns, times 100 is 114, and if you tap the 1000 you're moving at roughly 1 millimeter per step. So that's great for when you want to get close to it and you want to get the finest point. So I'm going to use the left hand right hand slider control here. So let's go back to the camera and I want to move the camera to the left, so I'm going to slide that slider to the left and the carriage will start to move back. If I give you the overhead view you can see this happening. So I'm going to move it back like so, and I want to look at the front edge of that image. You can see that it's fairly sharp there. I'm just going to take it a little bit further to the left so that front leading edge just goes out of focus, so I know that I'm in front of it, and then the leading edge will be captured for the video sequence. So that's just gone out of focus. So with the app, I now click the orange tick on the right hand side and that locks position A. Now I want to set position B again by just tapping the B on the app. And it's going to move the camera forward. and that will be to our last known B position, which is obviously too far for this. So we're going to move to the left for position B. So again, let's look at the camera, and you can see it's way behind, it's focused on the background. So I'm going to move the camera to the left. And we'll look at that image. You can see the back of the arm is just in focus. So let's just traverse to the right and see if we push it out of focus. Right, so that is behind the subject. So I'm going to click the tick on the right hand side, which locks position B. So I've locked position B. Now if we tap position A, it will drive the carriage to the left hand side. And you can see it's moved the carriage to just in front of the elbow, which is what we want. Now we need to look at the amount of movement. So clicking the arrow at the top of the app to take us back to the home screen. The total movement, if we look into the centre of the slider position there, is 5.0 centimetres. So the carriage will move 5 centimetres. But the movement per frame is we want to set is at the bottom there, 5.024. So the total movement is 5.04 and the movement we've got is 5.02. So providing that bottom movement is less than the total movement, we will get 2 frames. If it's more, you'll get 1 frame and this process won't work. So providing you are very close to your total movement and providing your app is showing you 2 frames in total, then this process will work. With the overhead view showing, I'm going to click the tick icon, which will start the process running. The camera will move back to the A position and then we'll start the video recording, and then it will run to the B position and stop recording, and then we'll see this from the camera perspective. So let me just hit the tick. So the camera is moving to the B position, and during that process it is starting to record. And now it's ended up at position B. If I click the tick, the camera will move back to the A position and start recording again. So I'll click the tick. So it's going back to the A position. And now we'll start recording and start to accelerate towards the B position. When it's reached the B position, it will stop recording. Let me show you that from an overhead perspective, and you can see the LCD screen on the camera. Obviously with HDMI connected, you can't see the LCD screen. So let me just take that out and reposition the camera for you. So now you can see the LCD screen and you should be able to see the record button start when we get back to position A. So again, I'll start the app running by clicking the tick. The camera will go back to position A. You'll see the recording start. It will move to position B and then you'll see this recording stop. So let me start the process. So it's going back to position A. Starts recording. Moves towards position B, gets to position B, and then stops recording. So you can see we've completely covered the subject. It's gone from position A to position B, which was the front to the back of the subject, to give us our roughly 2 seconds worth of video. We will have, say, 100 frames or 200 frames. Here I'm using 25 frames per second, so 2 seconds of video gives me roughly 200 frames. In Helicon Soft, that if you import that video into Helicon Soft, it converts those images into TIFF files, and then you can select, if you like, the start and end point if you're ahead or behind the subject to reduce the number of images that need to be stacked, but it will sort that out itself. So I prefer Helicon Soft, even though it is quite an expensive program. So that's how you create an MP4 video file to use for focus stacking. Obviously with the MIOPS Slider Plus, the increment per step is 1.014 microns. So you can see the very, very fine increments you could get if you've got a higher magnification. With a bellows and a microscope objective with the times 4 magnification, then you can get some very, very fine increments to photograph insect eyes and heads and that sort of thing. And I'll show you that in a later video. So the first thing we're going to do is to import that video file into our editing program. Here I'm using Helicon Soft, so File Import Video File. You can see that it now then goes through that video file and looks for each frame and converts it into a TIFF file. Once you click the render button at the bottom right hand side of the screen there, you'll see that it now builds up a bit depth map of each of the frames, and then finally it will composite those into one frame. You can see the process there, you can see it's building up the map to arrive at a final composite. So there we have the final composite. Click on the saving, rename the file, select where you want to save it, and then just click save, and it will save that file in a JPEG format with the location that you selected. Click the save button and it will save it as a JPEG with the quality specified by you. And here is the output file from that stacking process. Well, that's it for the video. I hope you did find that useful. Do check out my review of this Slider Plus. It's in the video description below. You'll find how to use this and more applications that you can get running on the MIOPS mobile app. So until the next video, as usual, thanks very much for watching. Please do take care. And I hope to see you all very, very soon. Goodbye for now.